Hello, beautiful people. Today we're gonna play with monsters, with vampires. And the main strategy here in this deck is to have Regis in your hand. And we need to utilize Imlerith in order to draw a card, then discard the card. If the discarded card was a unit, boost self by its power. So it means that if we're gonna discard Regis, we're gonna get 20 points automatically, and Imlerith will grow all the way to 23 points. Then we would like to use Ozzrel to get Regis once again from our graveyard, and then once again he will receive 20 points of boost, so he will be 21. So let me just walk you through all the cards and let's discuss the strategy. So since we are playing vampires, obviously the blood scent, this is gonna be our leader ability. Crystal Scar in order for our units not to get locked. Oneromancy for consistency. Unseen Elder, this is an amazing card. It gives us a huge tempo. In the first round it's played, then he gives 4 points of bleed, and then it's an automatic engine because every single turn he gives additionally 2 points of bleed. Currently Heatwave as a control option. Crimson Curse, it spawns 5 turns of Blood Moon. And then at the same time we're getting 2 Echimaras. Royal Decree for consistency. Orianna. And Orianna, she works super well if we're gonna play her in the same round with Crimson Curse and with Unseen Elder. It would be perfect if we could keep all these 3 cards for the last long third round. Then basically the tempo would be huge and amazing. Then we have 2 Pleathers, which are our super engines. Artifact Compression for the control. We have 2 Incubuses, and we play them usually in Pleathers. But sometimes, if the opponent doesn't have a 6 provision unit in his graveyard, then we can play them into Alps. For 5 points of provision, every Alp can give us 10 points. And also we can play Incubuses into Necurats, which are also our super engines. Spores for control, and 2 Fizz Bloods with a Purify in order to get rid of the defender status, and also it gives us 3 points of damage and 3 points of bleed. Pillar for the Purify for our units. Plummard, we need to play both of them in the same round, because one Plummard gives only 2 points of bleed, but the second one can give us as huge you know, bleed as the opponent power is, so it can be like 9 points or more. Then we have Bruxa as our engine with Thrive ability. So as you can see, this this deck is versatile. You have a few control options. You have a lock, you have Grunty Heatwave, and you have spores. You have spores and artifact compression. You have consistency thanks to Neuromancy and Royal Decree, and you also have huge units with super high power like Ozzrel and Imlerith. I would say that this deck is pretty versatile. You can challenge most of the decks, maybe not the metas, but it's a pretty decent deck. So just give it a shot, guys, and let me know in the comment section what do you think about it. So thank you very much for watching. Thank you for your time and support. Please like, subscribe, and comment, guys. See you in the next video. And last announcement, guys, please go to the nearest shelter and adopt a dog. Thank you very much, guys. Bye bye.
Best give up now! Long live acceptance.
Thank you.
Dead now! Killer spell!
Magic is all around. You need but reach out and grasp it.
Rubbish in, rubbish out, he said. Pass and forget. Not I.
You to fight like this.
satisfaction guaranteed. Renegades. We've no tolerance.
Naturally, of course.
Folks say we live like princesses. If only they knew.
Wager I can cast one with me foot.
Heal earthquakes, I have spoken.
We shall prevail.
You're one sexy witch, and I'm here to please.
Lady, your elegance does draw jealous eyes.
A plague. Parting spirit, what need you to flee this world ever free?
Time. with a mirror.
Who taught you to fight like this?